morning. My name is Russ Merrick. I'd like to welcome you to the manufacturing facility here at Merrick Machine Company, located in Alva, Nebraska. Today we have for you is our tilt window machinery. It's in our Ruvo product line of our millwork equipment. I'm going to go through some of the features and the benefits of the tilt window machine for you. Go through some of the operations to actually put a sample in, run it, touch on some of the controls. We have semi-automatic and fully automatic mode in the computer. It's a computer-driven machine. You've got a keypad on the right-hand side to go through all the controls and the different features. You can actually put a frame in here, clamp it up into place, then go ahead and screw, for instance, if you have brick mold or if you don't have brick mold. This machine can also be configured to do sash as well. Right now on this particular model, on this tilt window machine, we have roto-chamber heads. These are real typical of our T4 model we've been building for the last 40 plus years. The T4 head actually drives three staples. It actually pushes them into the wood. You're going to fire two from the bottom half first and then two from the top half. We can also configure these with pneumatic nail guns that independently stroke and fire one at a time in all four corners simultaneously. It all depends on what your needs are. The sample requirements that you send us dictates what we can get accomplished. If we can utilize the T4 heads, we will. If we have to index, we'll do that as well. The basic machine sits up at about a 75 degree angle. That's a fixed angle, it's not adjustable. It's ideal for loading parts in and unloading parts out real quick. The biggest thing you have to worry about is flow materials to and flow materials from the machine. Go through some real quick benefits here for you real fast. Number one, heavy duty construction. We have cast iron throughout as well as structural tubing. I'm going to kind of get down here low. We've actually got a rack and pinion drive system. The rack and pinion drive system runs along the bottom of the machine. Kind of get this shot here. It's encased in a housing assembly. Not only is it done on the bottom half of the machine to keep it in time in the rack, we also have a rack and pinion up on the top of the machine up as well. Try and get a shot of that towards the center here. Once again, encased in the cast iron housing that we have. There's actually four of those assemblies on the machine. You've got two on the top hand side and two on the bottom hand side. Everything has got a power cord management system on it. You've actually got a gore track here with a track guide system. Not only do you have it for the bottom half, each one of the corners has one. So there's one behind, difficult to see in the view, that runs up and down on either side. Real quick, you're going to say, well, what are the ranges? What can this do for me? Well, we can actually bring these heads in and we can get to 14 and a half inches by 19 inches, okay? That's your minimum. Now your maximum, you're going to go out to 56 inches for your height, okay? And my total overall length, we're going to go to 96 inches. Okay, that's maximum spread, 96 by 56. Those are the ranges. Sometimes, depending on the thickness of your window frames themselves, adjustments have to be made. That's why you send the samples in, we can take a look at them. Ideally, when you come to the point you need one of these machines, you're trying to increase production, this is an ideal machine to do it with. But we're looking for four samples from you. Number one, if I have four samples, I need one that's all nailed together exactly the way you want it, and I need loose samples so I can actually put them in the machine, test it, play with it, configure the corners to how they need to be. Okay, we're going to come back on this side once again. We've actually got encoders on the machine. It's a closed loop system, so we're entrapping all the information. We're sending it to the computer so it knows what's going on all the time. The other thing we have here is air regulator system on this side. If any time you hit the emergency stop button, we've got a dump valve over here that automatically kills the electricity and kills the air in the machine. So we're set up for a lockout tagout system as well. Now, all setup and operations of this machine are going to be covered in the manual. Especially, you're going to see a lot of pictures on the photos of the machine, how to identify parts, and a lot of information on how to actually operate the computer and what it does for you. All right, I'm actually going to grab some material, put it in here. Tell you what's going on here real quick. One of the things that happens, I'm actually taking the wood and I'm setting it on the base plates here of the T4 heads to try and get this shot here. And this is our actual working surface. If the machine was laying down, this is where the pieces would be laying on. In this case, we're actually setting them on the head itself. I've got a series of stops here. We're at 90 degrees, and on the sill side, get this back out of the way here a little bit, we've got an adjustable arm here. It's actually at the sill angle. We custom make that. Once again, everything's custom made. The clamps that actually come in, for, in this case, this particular customer ordered brick mold. He's got brick mold going around it. So we had to specially configure some clamps to come in and grab both pieces. Now it's grabbing both pieces in all four corners. You'll get a chance to see that here in just a second. Get all the pieces in the neighborhood here real fast. As I lay all the pieces in, it's not too terribly hard to get this going. I'm actually pulling the corner out, sliding the piece in, and there we are. So I just threw the pieces in. Actually going to bring the arm out. We actually have a tilt arm here. Depending on what size of window you have, if you're doing a really big window, let's say 80 inches, for instance, or 96, you're going to be out in this area. Just bring the controls closer to you in the area that you're working. Okay, now right now this is all set up. And I've actually got the screen set up to a full-size window in automatic mode. All I have to do is hit the green button, which indicates cycle start. The machine will actually come in, clamp from the top and the bottom, squeeze it. These clamps will come down, press against the brick mold, and the rotor chamber heads will fire. I'm going to go ahead and do that. You guys can go ahead and watch. All I have to do is hit cycle start. It's coming in, it's squeezing. Fired the bottom first, and then fired the top set of guns. All said and done, the machine automatically opens up on its own. Now, let me show you that one more time so you can see what I'm talking about. It actually came in and clamped, and when it did, it actually released and opened up further than before, just a little bit, so you can actually get the material out. The trick that you need to do is grab hold of the sill side with your right hand, push everything up against the thick side on your left, and then pull it right on out, stick it on a conveyor, some other station or cart, and keep right on moving. Once again, it's fairly solid. If you've got brick mold, a lot of people actually take their brick mold and start screwing it in place. There's actually a semi-automatic operation. In semi-automatic operation, you could actually come in, clamp, but not fire the tool, and put a screw in here if you wanted to screw your brick mold together in the four corners. There's plenty of real estate to get that done. Once again, we configure that at the time of the order. All right. I'm gonna get this out of the way. Come back in. Once again, we've got main cast iron bases here. We've got screw leads on either side. A lot of power going on here. We actually dial the machine down. We have enough force if you got a really large frame that you need a lot of pressure with. We dial the machine down to its minimum just to accommodate everybody, and we can go up from there. Real nice advantage. Once again, swing arm controls, works really nice. All the main controls are on the back side of the machine. Each one of the Triad machines or the Ruble machines that we manufacture in the millwork industry all come with a transformer on them. What does that mean to you, our customer? That means you have one hookup, not two. Transformer actually located on the rear of the machine, on the left-hand side over here. There's also a quick disconnect. All the controls in the computer and the main control box on the back side. We have, go through some other things with you. We've got some wear gibs that are actually incorporated in the cast iron. The wear gibs are actually located on all four castings of the machine, and on the rack and pinion castings on the top and bottom. That's great for low maintenance. The other thing we have here, you can actually put 396 staples. I'm gonna run around this side, try and get you a better shot here. This is our T4 head. Like I said, we've been building this for over 40 years. You can actually put 396 staples in this thing, load it all up, and go after production. Ideally, just put the staples on the track, let the follower loose, close the lid on it to make sure they stay in position and locked, especially when they're upside down position so they won't fall out on you, and go ahead and start firing the machine. This is the tilt window machine. Once again, it's part of our Ruvo product line of our millwork. This machine actually comes with an installation. Service guy comes, installs the machine for you. It's also got a series of leveling feet. There's four of them total. They're located at the bottom of the machine. You probably won't be able to see them in this shot, but it needs to be anchored to the floor, get into position, and air lines as far as how much air is required. We're looking around 100 psi generally. And the other thing is, please look at your manual as far as how to get air to it. We want to try and run as big a line as possible. Okay, once again, we've also, one last thing I'll touch on, is we've got about 14 degrees that we adjust on the sill side over here. This 14 degrees is actually accommodated in this casting, this rotor chamber head that we have here for the T4. The casting has a bracket on the back side that's slotted, so we can actually bring this to 90 degrees if it was required. We can bring it back to 14 or any combination from 0 to 14 in between. Real benefit. Once again, this is the tilt window machine. We can do a sash with it and so forth, brick mold or without brick mold on window frames. Clamping and so forth are available. If you have any questions, please call the factory at 1-800-568-7423. Once again, my name is Russ Merrick, and I'd like to thank you for your time.